What's up, my fellow party animals? Today we're going to be talking about one of my favorite people in the whole wide world. His name is Jake Paul. He has a big, huge fight coming up. It's going to be on August 29th. I just wanted to reminisce about all my favorite memories hearing about him. He's been famous for about five or six years, actually. He started back up in 2015 with Vine. I think we all know this guy. I remember back a couple years ago, I was on Vine a lot, and I remember seeing Logan Paul was like, oh, there's his brother too, Jake. It's Jake too. So I would see Logan doing all these funny things, and I have remembered that he had a brother named Jake. Eventually, Jake got more and more famous, more and more famous. Now, today, who is more famous out of Jake and Logan? I don't know. But this video is about Jake. Let's go through all these memories. Hope you guys enjoy. This is one of the most recent memories we have of him. His house got searched by the FBI. We know if someone's house gets searched by the FBI, they're obviously doing something good. The FBI only searches people who are doing good things. I bet Jake had the cure for cancer in there or something. Maybe renewable energy that never runs out. But his house getting searched clearly shows that he's a good person. Another reason why I really like Jake Paul is because he got booted off Disney for bothering his neighbors. This might actually confuse you guys, but it shows me that Jake knows how to stand up for something. His neighbors were complaining that Jake was causing so much disruption in the neighborhood, but Jake just stood up for what he believed in, and that is something that I look up to. It got so bad that Disney had to kick him off, and Jake didn't even care. He kept doing what he was doing. Nothing can stop this kid. I mean, he has the willpower like a wild lion in Africa. I really like this guy. He even got sued by his landlord for $2.5 million. That makes me like him even more. Who else do you know that got sued for that much? Did you get sued for that much? Wouldn't you want to get sued for that much? So this is a really big reason why I like him a lot. He tells the kids the truth about school. How school is not important and you can still make money and be rich, even if you drop out, just like Jake did. We should just tell all of our kids that. It would help our kids so much if they knew that they didn't need school at all. They just go to school for 8 hours a day and it just wastes all their time. Imagine how much extra time they would have if they knew this truth that Jake is teaching them. But we can't stop there. Jake knows that school's not all that bad. I mean, he made his own course called Edfluence. This course that he made called Edfluence not only taught kids about buying things, but also how to not get scammed. If you buy this Edfluence course for the initial $7 back when it was available in 2018, you would buy the $7 course, and then when you get into the portal for the course, then there's another paywall for $57 for the rest of the videos. So this was really cool that Jake did this for all these kids. I mean, all of his followers around ages 10 to 12, maybe. He taught them about scamming right when they were in that ripe age of getting online and buying things themselves. They really needed that lesson from him, and he gave it. No one asked him to do that for them. No one asked him if he could tell the kids about scamming. He just did it for their benefit. And he also taught these kids about how fast the internet moves, because if you look up this site, it doesn't even exist anymore. All those kids who bought it and wanted to become famous and popular and make all this money, they don't even have access to those videos anymore. They just wasted the $64. But he didn't stop there with the education system. He also made his own course called the Financial Freedom Movement that you pay $20 for. I didn't look into this course very much, but him making this course just shows you that he's not trying to make money off these kids. He's trying to teach these kids how to make money. That's all he cares about, is helping these kids make money. I mean, he could just put these videos on his YouTube channel, and he could just even make a finance channel, but he doesn't want to do that. He wants to make this program tailored to each and every one of those kids, and this website with the $20 paywall is how he does that the best way he can. Jake also teaches us how to make babies. I know he hates the education program, how they're teaching all the kids sex ed, and he thinks that should be from their parents. But also, Jake is taking that position for the parents too. If you watch his videos, you're usually going to find some content that's a little NSFW. Usually it's a little raunchy, sometimes it's a little risque. But that's good. He's teaching all these kids for us. We don't need to waste our time doing that. He's going to do it for us. We think we need to teach our kids the real things about how to create a family and how to start a family. No, Jake can do that for us. We don't need to waste our time. Just right along that, he teaches us that marriage is all about money. He got married, I think, twice in the past 5 years, one with Erica Costell and one with Tana Mongeau. Did he love these girls? Well, if you look at the videos that he made for them, he says they're all about money, and Hannah Mongeau's wedding was a really big production. It had about a $600 million value as far as media value goes. This is a good thing. This shows us if we want to get married, just marry someone rich. Just marry someone who can make us a lot of money. It doesn't matter if you love them. It doesn't matter if they're compatible. It doesn't matter if you love them. Just marry them just because they have money. Just marry them because you're gonna make money. And even to go a little bit deeper in the relationship area with Jake Paul, his girlfriend Alyssa Violet that he had back in 2017, I believe. If you watch how their relationship was, that is the best kind of relationship you could ever wish for. I know Alyssa was saying that he was dragging her down the stairs and bruising her, and he broke her iPhone a couple times, and he was cheating on her with other girls constantly, every week, every day. He had a new girl with him in the apartment. But isn't that how we want our kids to be? Don't we want to teach them that that's how our kids are going to have successful relationships? I mean, all of our kids should be looking up to this guy. I can't believe that he's not on the wall right now. I'm going to frame him and put him on my wall. Teach my kids that this is the true person you should be looking up to. He also taught us that looting and rioting helps the nation when the nation is facing something big. I remember when the George Floyd riots were happening and we saw a video of Jake with all of his friends looting the mall. I just felt so inspired by that. I feel like after he did that, then nothing was wrong anymore. I felt at ease, and I hope all of you guys did too. I just felt so good seeing him in that store participating with all the looting and stealing. It just made me feel so good about where we are in our nation. It fixed everything from George Floyd. And this is one of the biggest things and probably one of the most controversial things, but it's something that makes me like him the most. Back when the pandemic started, he was saying the virus was a hoax and everything. It was just something the government was using to shut the people down. And I stand with everything that Jake says, even on this topic, even though I had two of my friends' dads die from this virus. I still stand with Jake. I know that it was a hoax that killed my friends' dads. The government is just using it to shut us all down. This is probably my one thing that I have against Jake. I think he should have said instead, the government should let the people decide themselves if they want to take care of themselves. This thing that's going around is kind of something that if you decide you're going to be healthy, then you can be healthy. But it is really dangerous for old people, so old people stay inside. But still, it is a hoax. It is a hoax. Thank you, Jake. It is a hoax. The last thing I super like about Jake so much is that he taught us about anxiety. And the truth is that anxiety is just from us. We create anxiety. If we don't want anxiety, we can go out, we can take a walk, we can talk to friends, but it's our fault if we're anxious. Even though he told us this truth about anxiety, he later said, well, anxiety is real. I have anxiety. So this backtracking and going back and forth really makes me like him even more. But anyways, that is why I like Jake Paul. I hope you guys like him too. Comment things that you like about him. Comment what you agreed with. Like and subscribe. Share this with all your friends. And bye. I love you. But just to be real for a second, I do believe each individual person has the most control of themselves, and anxiety can be treated many different kinds of ways. It's different for every person. I actually think anxiety comes from the lizard monsters that are hiding in the earth. It's not from within ourselves. It's from them. So, sorry, Jake. And on the pandemic thing, I don't think the government is using it to try to keep us down. I think aliens sent it here and are using it to try and depopulate the earth so they can use the earth instead of us. And it's not working really well. It only killed about 200,000 to about 1 million. So they're not doing very well. I think they sent this Delta variant out after they realized the original one wasn't going to be as good. But I mean, that's what I think about it. Jake was a little bit wrong on this. That's about it, guys. Have a good day. Love you. Subscribe so much. This video is stupid. Bye. Love you.